police source is saying that when the athletes got to this gas station, they were drunk, that they tore a sign off one of the walls there, effectively vandalizing it. But then the staff there and those athletes came to some sort of accommodation where they agreed, when police arrived, that charges weren't necessary to be filed against them. So a scene there, it doesn't necessarily sound like the altercation we've heard from a separate source that may have occurred there. There's been a suggestion in a key Brazilian media outlet here, Globo, which released the CCTV, you may see shortly, that in fact they urinated in a side alleyway there. The CCTV that's been released does purport to back some of that up. But we're on a broader scale here, talking about a fairly small altercation at a gas station here, in which the police source says no weapons were actually drawn. But somehow this scuffle or dispute merited, it appears, certainly if you listen to the Brazilian side of the story here, an enormous excuse to be made up by Mr. Lochte, who referred to how he was actually the victim of an armed robbery perpetrated by men disguised as police. Now, we have not heard from Mr. Lochte, his attorney. We've asked for comment from him. Mr. Lochte, as of yesterday, was sticking by his original story, although subsequent interviews have suggested discrepancies in that story. But there is now a fairly consistent picture we're hearing from Brazilian authorities, backed up by the search and seizure warrants released by a court, no less, here yesterday. A police source also telling us they believe the investigation has shown that there was not actually a robbery there. You'll see this CCTV increasing, I think, calls for a better explanation from Mr. Lochte and the swimmers, and possibly also, too, from US Olympic officials. Now, the first suggestions there may have been discrepancies in the swimmers' story emerged earlier this week. But people are now, of course, asking, what point did the US Olympic Committee know there may have been a problem with the story? When did Brazilian authorities present them with that information? And if they were misled for a lengthy period of time, what reprimands potentially might there be against the athletes? A lot of questions to be answered here. I should point out again, we have not heard from Mr. Lochte or any of the other three swimmers, Mr. Gunnar Bentz, Jack Conger, and James Fegan. We haven't heard their side of the story, and the last time we did, they said they stuck to what they originally had said.